Okay, so what I want to explain is a joint work with Peng Shan, and it is related also to work by Bezrokhannikov. And Yuki. So, what I want to explain is a new connection between G1T modules in positive characteristics and a fine Springer theory. And so, to begin with, I just want to say to recall the construction due to Brandan. So, for GLN, so which is the following. So, you fix your GLN, you have the category O over C, usual category O. And you fix, say, some composition nu and mu of n. So it means there are tuples in tuple of non-negative integers which sum to n. And to this tuple you can associate two things. First you can associate, so I will say mu, it's the singular block. So in O it's a singular block. It means that you take the Serre subcategory generated by simple modules, lambda plus of highest weight lambda such that lambda plus rho, where rho is half the sum of the positive root, so you see it as a tuple, and you fix the number of entries as exactly mu I entries equal to I. So it's a tuple, so mu is okay. And after, you can also consider the inside there is a parabolic category so which means that in the category O you impose that the modules are semi-simple with respect to the Cartan and are locally finite with respect to the Borel. Here you impose that the modules are locally finite for a parabolic for P nu, which is a parabolic of type nu. And you can intersect both. And it is known that this is a block of O nu for each nu. And now there is on this category there is what are called the categorical actions. So in this particular setting, it is a categorical action of the Lie algebra GL infinity. Of GL infinity. It means that on GL infinity, you take the Serre presentation with functors, with generators EI, FIs, and Z, and you impose that the EI, FIs act on the category, EI, FI, act on, so I will take the sum over, over all mu, the composition of N, of O, mu, and nu, by what I call the translation functor. So it means for EI, you take a representation, you tensor it by by C to the n, and you take a particular piece which corresponds to some eigenvalue of the Casimir, which depends on I. And for if I, you take a dual picture. Okay. And then you apply a general procedure, which is the following, which goes back to Bernstein. So suppose that you have a category C and that you have some a pair of adjoint functors. So B adjoint pair. Then you can product from this some operator on the center. So you have the center of Z that you view as the endomorphism of the identity functor. So I can write two categories, it does not change a lot. And so you produce from this some operators, Zi, which goes from the center of C1 to the center of C2, and essentially it is of the following. So if you take an element here, so what you begin, you want you begin with an element with an endomorphism of the identity functor of C1, and you want to produce an element, an endomorphism of the identity functor of C2. So you begin by the identity of C2, you apply the the unit of some adjunction, so C1F. On this, you apply Z. So you arrive here. And then you apply the. So this is a unit for one adjunction, and you take the co-unit for the other adjunction. And so you arrive to E1 of C2. And so you take the composite of all this. Okay. And so what you get from all this is the following. So you have the following theorem. First, you can compute the center of each of this piece. So it is a cohomology of what is called the Spaltenstein variety. So I will explain just below. And the second result is that what you get an action of GL infinity acts, the Lie algebra acts on the center. And this can be described explicitly. What the resulting representation is essentially a tensor product of wedge given by a new k of C infinite. I think it's a thing like this. If I'm under. Yes, it's okay. And so, what is the spatial chain variety? So it means that first you consider this is a set of flags, the flag variety of type nu of GLn of type mu, and then you fix an nilpotent element of type nu, gamma nu. And you consider all the flags which are fixed in the strict sense by the nilpotent element. It means that the nilpotent element should be it's a nilpotent radical. So you mean so f mu is the set of all parabolics of type mu, and f mu nu is the set of all parabolic like this, such that so gamma nu belongs to the nilpotent radical. So this is a Spallation variety. Okay, so what I want to explain is that there is a version of this involving a fine Springer theory and a modular representation of what is called G1T. So first I want to say make some recall on G1T modules. Okay, so I will begin with G. So Brunton theorem was for GLN. What I will explain is it holds for any type. So G is connected, simply connected. So and semi-simple over K, which is algebraically closed, of characteristic P. And the characteristic P will be good. It means essentially that it is not two or three, in some sense. And we take the maximal torus. And X, the character group of T, character lattice. And inside this, you have the root lattice. Okay, now we consider the Lie algebra of G over the field K. So it's a P Lie algebra. It means that there is an operation often written like this. And you form from this what is called the restricted. So what I would have to say, so I will explain a version characteristic positive. There is also a version for quantum group at root of unity also. Everything has an analog. But I will keep the point of view of modular geometry. Okay, so we can form from this the restricted enveloping algebra. So UP of G, which is a quotient of the enveloping algebra by the two-sided ideal generated by all the X pi P minus X P. X is in G. And what I am interested in is not exactly G1T module, is first I want to explain what are deformed, it's a more general version, deformed G1T module. So to do this, first observe that this, so the representation category of this is the same as the representation of the Frobenius kernel. So it is Morita equivalent to UP of G. And now what I want, instead of looking to the Frobenius kernel, which is a subgroup of G, I want to consider the subgroup which is indirected by the Frobenius kernel and the maximal torus. So it's what is called G1T. And the algebra corresponding to this is the following. So you just do a slight modification on the Cartan term here. So I take U. So I only take this operation on non-Cartan terms. a question by the two-sided allele generated by all E alpha pi and F alpha pi. So F alpha is the root. So it is known for this element, the square operation is zero. So in such a way that this, the G1T, G1 is obtained from U by adding for all Cartan terms this. You have to put alpha or root. Okay, it's an intermediate object which has so it has a triangular decomposition. And here, what I impose that this is a full polynomial algebra, while usual from Frobenius kernel is smaller. See. Okay, now what I want to introduce is, as I said, a deform representation of this. So I fix R, K algebra, that I will suppose local in general, and with a morphism of algebra from U0 to R. And we consider the following category, so of deformed geometric module. So R deformed, say. So the object are graded module over U tensor R. So it's M, which is X gradient module. Over U tensor R. And with a condition, so M is the sum over all nu of the weight space. And you have a condition with respect to the Cartan element in the enveloping algebra. The weight condition is of the following type. So if M is a new component, so this it is M. So I make act R from the right just to not to confuse the two action, and so you have P of H alpha plus nu of H alpha, which I have this. So it means that in the usual case, this is a scalar, is just a weight. So you put this, but you deform by an element in R, which is this element. So I will call this H alpha. So this element here. Okay, there is two typical, two extreme cases of deformation that are important, say. So the first one is you do not deform anything. So two typical examples. So it means that you take for k for r simply the base field, and p from u0 to k is the augmentation map. And so you obtain a usual C of k is a usual not deform G1T module. And the other one, that's the most extreme, you take R maximal, so you take for pi, so you take a localization of U in general. It will be, so R is localization of U. Of U not. And, okay. So now just, so considering this category, so there are some standard tools on this category. So I have to recall a few things. So you have the affine viral group. And you consider its P version. P of Q. And to deal with modules in the category CR, what is convenient is the combinatorics of alcoves, as mentioned by Peter just before. So we just very briefly. So A is a set of alcoves, it means you take the R linear span of the weight and you remove from this all the affine root hyperplanes. So alpha is a root. So and M is an integer. And H alpha M is a set of all elements Z such that alpha chetch Z is equal to M. And there is the affine reflection with respect to H alpha M. H alpha M. And you introduced an operation, so if I do a picture, the picture in the case of A2, so you have like this. So this here you have this is a set of alcove, it's not so you this alcove here label by element of the Val group. That's one S2. And you want to write an operation. So each hyperplane so has a label. This is alpha 3, 0. So alpha 3 is alpha 1 plus alpha 2. So alpha 3 minus 1, alpha 3, 1. And here it is alpha 1 minus 1, I guess. Alpha 1, alpha 1, 1. And after it's alpha 2, it's the same thing. Hein? Alpha 2, etc. And so when parallel hyperplane are labeled by a root, and you want to define an operation which associates to an alcove. An alcove which is just symmetric with respect to a wall of a given root. So it is the operation like this. When you have a weight, so and alpha is a root. So you want to define. So is the operation like this. So it is algebraically it is the following definition. So where if n alpha different from p, else, and where n alpha, so you take alpha plus rho, you pair it with alpha chetch, lambda plus rho, and so it is an integer, and you take the residue modulo p. Residue in 1 p of the following integer. Okay, and this is the operation is what I say. So you take, when you have an alcove, you take the symmetric with respect to an hyperplane of color alpha, and you do it downstairs. It means that in the opposite of the positive direction determined by the Weyl chamber. So this is another operation which is completely symmetric upstairs. So from this, you can describe, in particular, there is what is called the linkage, which permits to describe the block of the category. So the linkage says that, so in this theory, you have as usual, as in usual highest weight category, you have a notion of standard module. So here they are played by what are called baby Verma modules. So they are labeled by element in the weight lattice, lambda. And so I put an R for the deformation and so you take U tensor by U0 U plus of R of lambda. So this is a free R module of rank 1 such that U plus act by 0 and U not by the weight lambda. And when R is a field, then you have the irreducible module are exactly the top of all these R lambdas. And so what the linkage say in this case? Is that the multiplicity of delta lambda in the simple module? So I will write this by L. Is non-zero if and only if you obtain mu from lambda by applying this operation. So if mu is a form beta 1, beta 2, beta k apply to lambda. Enfin, if. So just like this. And so this yields a block decomposition of the category. So CR is the sum of CR mu, and mu is a weight, and you quotient by action of WP. So the block decomposition up to sum, to simplify, it's actually labeled by the orbit of the Feinwald group from this. And so this is a category generated by the delta R lambdas such that lambda plus rho is W conjugate to mu plus rho. So all this is a standard construction which goes back to Janssen. So the first result is the following. So suppose that the deformation is assume R is generic. So it was the second example that I mentioned before. So you can compute the center of this category, and it is given by the following formula. So you take tuples labeled by element in the weight lattice, and such that you have some congruence relation, which means of the following type: A is equal to A alpha lambda mod H alpha for all alpha a positive root and for all lambda in X. So H alpha was the element in the in the deformation ring R, which correspond to the Cartan element big H alpha, and this is the relation that I have introduced just before. And using the root decomposition, you can this is the center of the whole category. You can express the center of each block by intersecting to the condition. So C R is the sum of mu of C R mu. And so the center of C R is the sum of mu of the centers of C mu R. And what you get is that the center of C mu R is the same thing, but so the representation theoretic meaning of R alpha correspond to the alpha is it's an action on one particular baby Verma module labeled by lambda. So you just consider here only the element in the fixed orbit. And so you obtain a lambda in pi of lambda in W dot P of mu of R satisfying this, I will call this the GKM condition. Satisfying the GKM condition. And this is a dot action, it's a W dot of mu is W of mu plus rho minus rho for all W in W hat. So this is, say, for the algebraic side. And now there is a long-long dual geometric side. So I will come back to this formula later. So it's the following. Now you take the dual group. So it's over C. And you consider some flag varieties. So I will fix sigma, the set of affine roots, affine simple roots. And each time I have a finite subset. Enfin, for each subset J, you consider the corresponding paraboric type affine variety. So this is a loop group for the dual for J-Chetch, and you quotient by a paraboric. And PJ is a paraboric subgroup associated to J. So it's an affine flag partial affine flag manifold. And we consider, as in the JLN case I mentioned before, the corresponding affine spatial variety. So I fix the role of the nilpotent element is fixed here by a semi-simple element so this is a ring of integer in my local field. X was a weight lattice as before, which corresponds to the co-weight lattice of J-Chetch. And this is so I see it as a you see you. Should see it as a semi element as a semi simple element in the over the with satisfying some integrality condition in the carton of this over the field of formal series. And so you consider the corresponding variety. So you take all the, you make act an element of the group on a parabolic by adjoint action. And of type G, everything of type G. So X is in the loop group. And you impose that this element is in the pronilpotent radical. So x minus 1 gamma goes to nil. So this is a topological radical of the Lie algebra of the parabolic. Okay. And so a priori, so at the beginning G was semi-simple, so G-chat is adjoint, so it means there are several connected components. I will restrict to only one connected component. So I fix once for all the connected component of the base point, which is PIG. And so it is gamma G, it is Y gamma G, intersected connected component of PG. So what is this object? For the moment, it has not a lot of structure, but one can do some restriction in gamma. So the first restriction is that gamma is semi-simple, is regular semi-simple. View as element over the field of formal series. And so this, by Cashan and Lusik, this implies that this Spechtelten variety is of finite dimensional. But it is not a variety, it's an end variety. In general, there is an infinite number of connected components. So there is a standard restriction, so the Fein-Springer theory has often been studied under another condition in gamma, which is that gamma is elliptic. So this means that there is when you take the central other of gamma in the loop group, it should not contain any split torus. So this means there is no non-trivial morphism like this. There is no non-trivial. So we will not do this. I will have a comment on this later, but a priori, we will not do this hypothesis. We will restrict to this situation. So the element we have in mind, it is of the following. You take an element, semi-simple element in X, you tensor by epsilon, viewed as element in the formal series, and you assume that S is regular in X, say. So these are the elements we are interested in. So this hypothesis is satisfied, but not this one. And so this type of element have also a nice property. It is what is called homogeneous. It means that when you make rotate on when you apply the sister action by rotation on this, so the characteristic polynomial is actually changed by a scalar. You see, it's everything. There is only one power of epsilon here, which is involved. And it has several consequences on the geometry of xj gamma. So what is known is that the cohomology of this is pure, in the Lin sense. And in particular, it implies that it is what is called equivalently formal. So it means that the JKM method applied to compute the cohomology using fixed point. And I have said it is of infinite type. This I already mentioned, but finite dimensional. So the typical example, just to have a slight idea of what is involved. If you look to the case of SL2, So in this case, the x gamma. So g is empty set. So the x gamma is simply an infinite union of p1 which intersects transversely and labeled by integers. So what is known more about the geometry of this x gamma? So when g is empty, in the case of full flags, I will simply remove everywhere the index j. So if you look to this variety, say for example, so in this particular case, so the geometry of the irreducible component is rather complicated. What is known is that there is one irreducible component which is isomorphic to g of a b. This is one irreducible component. I should have said here that it is equidimensional. All irreducible components have the same dimension. And after, there is an infinite number of other components, irreducible components. And the irreducible components are labeled by elements in the affine Weyl group. So the bijection between the irreducible component and the element in the affine Weyl group. In this case, all irreducible components are the same, but this is not true in general. And on the cohomology of this, there is an action of Weyl group. I will recall this later. There is what is called the Springer representation. Springer action. So if you, for example, consider the top dimensional cohomology of x gamma. And so there is an action of w hat, which is a Springer action, Lustig Springer action. This setting. So this representation, it is more or less known. It means that the lattice of Korut acts by translation on each irreducible component. They are labeled by W hat. You can translate here by element of the root lattice. If you take, for example, this. So it is known that this action restricts an action of W, which is a regular representation. This goes back to some computation due to Lustig, indeed. But already at this level, which is say the simple part, if you remove this, it is not known exactly what representation of W hat is involved. So things are a bit complicated. Okay, so now I can formulate the second theorem. So I fix an element in the Weyl lattice, and I will suppose that mu plus rho is in the closure of the what is called the fundamental alcove. This is the alcove which was labeled by the element 1 in the affine Weyl group. This is the fundamental alcove. Okay. So the walls of this alcove are labeled by hyperplane, labeled by roots, and fix J, a subset of simple roots associated inside sigma. The walls are labeled by simple affine. Root sigma, and so fix a subset of the simple root such that which correspond to the facet in which this element is. So it means that such that the centralizer in the P the centralizer of mu for the dot action in WP hat. This is of parabolic type J. So I fix the parabolic type of the centralizer of my element mu. Okay, I begin with a weight, and I fix the parabolic type, I call it J, in this sense. I assume that the parameter deformation is generic. Also. And then what we have, there is an algebra, an R algebra isomorphism. From the center of the block labeled by mu. So it was this. I recall the deformed G1T category, the block mu, and this was the center. And so it is isomorphic to the other ring, to the equivalent cohomology with respect to the torus of this corresponding parabolic type of Sperl-Cheltenham variety with coefficient in my field, algebraic closed field of positive characteristics. And here, this is an R algebra. I have to explain where does the R algebra structure, R module comes from here. You tensor this by, this is a module over the cohomology of the point. And this is exactly what I call U naught at the beginning. And R is the localization of it. So I just localize. So we have this algebra isomorphism. And so the idea of the proof is it goes back to GKM methods in positive characteristics. So I consider cohomology. What is important here is to use cohomology and not homology. So Borel-Moore homology gives a different result a priori, and it is in positive characteristics. What? I have fixed once for all. It was, I recall, it was like this. S regular semisimple. So this is at the level of generic deformation. So the idea is that the deformation parameter of this block corresponds in some sense to the action here. So there is a guess what should happen if we remove this deformation, but it is still not proved. So I will write the conjecture. Is that so? In the non-deform setting, so it means I with the notation of before, I put here just a small k. So it should be exactly the cohomology, the non-equivalent cohomology. I want to mention it is not a geometric problem. It's as I said, this variety has formal because gamma is homogeneous, so everything be as well with respect to change of action of the group. The problem is on the algebraic side. It's there that this statement is not easy to prove. So this is just an identification as ring, so it is compatible with the multiplication. Structure is the region for which I consider cohomology and not homology. But it is also considered compatible with Springer action. So the following. So if you just fix. So I take no parabolic type to simplify, and so here is the affine spatial variety. So in the non-parabolic type, it is the same thing as the usual affine Springer fiber. You take the cohomology with respect to my field of positive characteristics, equivariant, and I can also take a zero element. It's the usual affine flavor variety, so no gammas. So this is usual complete affine flags. So on this, there is two actions of the affine viral group. There is one action which comes from multiplication. So you write this as an homogeneous space, and you can multiply by an element of the group by the left or from the right, and so it gives rise to two actions of W. So the left action and the right action, which is the Springer action, and both actions descend to the. So there is a restriction map. And both actions descend to the affine Springer fiber, okay? To the cohomology of the affine Springer fiber. And, okay. So now, I suppose that the characteristic is large enough, it means greater than the Coxeter number. So this is just, this condition is easy, is just to imply that there is a regular block. So, it means that there is an integer weight in the fundamental alcove, and it means that there is a well-defined regular block. Okay, so regular. Regular block in the category of modules. Okay. Okay, now if you may vary the block, there is a notion of translation functor here as in the category O. So they were introduced years ago by Janssen. So if you took two weights, you have some mu are weights up to conjugation by the affine viral group, which labels the blocks as before. And there is a canonical bi-adjunction. Between the functors. And so you can consider the wall crossing functor. So you do the following. Suppose your weight, for example, is in the fundamental alcove. So in the A2 picture, it was IV, the fundamental alcove, labeled by 1 in the viral group. And here you have reflection with respect to, so it's S0, which is S alpha 3. Minus 1, S alpha 1, S alpha 2. You have this sort of picture. So you fix you fix a weight mu in A plus here. Mu plus rho, excuse me, so it's a shift by rho. A plus. And you fix one wall labeled by a simple affine root, which is in the here. You fix a mu s on some mu plus, and s is an affine viral group. Is an affine simple reflection labeled by this labeled by rho. Fix mu s in x such that mu s plus rho is so it is on the wall of this. And so you can consider this T mu s, mu s mu, T mu mu s, theta s. So it goes from C, C mu r to C mu r. You compose the functor and the adjoint functor. And it is what is called the wall crossing functor. It's labeled by each simple reflection, a fine simple reflection. And so you can apply the general formulas I mentioned before and write a corresponding operator in the center. And I fix mu inside A plus, so this is a regular block. So I have a European thing like this. So for each simple affine root, I have an operator on the center, excuse me, I've forgotten to write the center, yeah, on the regular block of the G20 module. So you can put them together. The claim is that they generate, so they generate an action of the affine Weyl group, which is isomorphic to the affine Springer representation. On this, which is isomorphic. To the Springer W hat action on the cohomology of the affine Springer fiber. So, alors, action. On H de X gamma. Okay. So everything is compatible from this point of view. So now I want to explain, this is say what we know, and after there is several conjectures. For generic, because always for R generic. So what are one motivation of to look to this was some conjecture of concerning the center of the small quantum group, or of G1T, of G1 if you prefer. So as I explained at the beginning, you have say two algebras. There is G1, the Frobenius Cornell, which corresponds to, which is more equivalent to the restricted enveloping algebra. And there is G1T, you had a grading by the torus. This is a grading version of this, which is more equivalent to U module. Okay, and this is okay, Morita. So everything I have said for the moment is on this column, and here there is a deformation. We add some deformation. So everything was here, but one question is what is the center of the UP of G. More precisely, this is a finite dimensional algebra. The center is an honest finite dimensional ring, and there are several blocks. So you take and so there is this, the center. It decomposes according to the blocks of this ring, and I want to. There is a particular block which contains the regular block, and I want to understand what is this commutative ring. So the center of the of this, or its quantum counterpart, which is a small quantum group, is not known. And one question is, what is this algebra? And so if for G in type A, there is a conjecture. For this. So I suppose that P is bigger than the Coxeter number, as before, and I take G of SLR. And so there is a Fourier conjecture, Flash-Oscar and Key, which says that the dimension of this, so the conjecture comes from different origins. They did some computation in Hochschild cohomology using localization procedure of modular localization of Bezrukhannikov, Mirkovich, and Rubenin. And the center of this, center should be R plus one, R minus one. And so this is known to be what is called in Heimann theory, it's the dimension of the covariant, diagonal covariant ring. So you take function and two copies of CR, and you quotient by you take the element with no constant term, which are diagonally SR invariant. Plus, it means you don't take constant term and you take this. This is what are called diagonal invariant harmonics. And there is an action of the symmetric group on this. It comes with an action of the symmetric group. And it is known that to be equal as a ring, as a representation, it coincides to another Springer fiber, which is affine Springer fiber, which is the following. So you take an element, a new element, so not gamma, gamma prime. So positive, and so which is elliptic this time, and I will not write a formula, but you can characterize by the characteristic polynomial, such as the characteristic polynomial of gamma prime, so applied to x, it is xr minus epsilon r plus 1. So this is an element which was first introduced by Lustig, and which is appear everywhere. And in this case, it is known that the cohomology of the S-Pan Springer fiber is exactly this.
We're running a little over, so do you mind?
Okay, so I will just finish quickly to this conjecture. And so what it suggests is a refinement of the conjecture of the following. So I take the element as I introduced before. So there is an action, there is two actions on this, as I said. You take, for the left action, you take this is WCQ. So for the left action, you take the invariant for the lattice part. Okay, so this does not act. There is still the Springer action, which acts on this. And this is supposed to be exactly the center of the small quantum group in this case. So it's supposed to be this. Diagonal, voilà. Harmonic. And this, using the description of the deformed center that I have explained, this, using the previous result, you can relate this to what you can prove. Theorem. This exactly contains the center of the small quantum group. So this comes from the previous theorem. So the conjecture is that this is inequality, and this is inequality. So there is two statements, A and B.
which gives which in particular will give a complete description of the of this algebra in the case of type A. Okay, so I will stop here for the moment.